Welcome to Manifested Publishers.
Hello, learners. My name is Stephen Kariungi. I welcome you to our today's topic of discussion. The topic is chlorine and its compounds. This topic is offered at Form 3 level, and it's one of the major topics that are tested in KCSE. Now, the first thing that we'll do before we get into the details about chlorine and its compounds, we'll discuss the chapter objectives. What are the requirements for every learner by the end of this particular chapter? The first objective, a learner should be able to describe the preparation, properties, and uses of chlorine. The second objective is also to be able to describe the preparation of hydrogen chloride, which is one of the compounds of chlorine. Objective number three is to describe the effect of a solvent on the properties of hydrogen chloride. Number four, to describe and explain the large-scale manufacture, of hydrochloric acid. And lastly, number five is to explain the pollution effects of chlorine and its compounds. So those are the objectives of this particular chapter. The first objective is to be able to prepare chlorine gas, discuss its properties and uses. Objective number two, to describe the preparation of hydrogen chloride gas, its properties and also uses. And number three, to describe the effect of a solvent on properties of hydrogen chloride. Number four, we shall describe and explain the large-scale manufacture of hydrochloric acid. And lastly, number five, we shall explain pollution effects of chlorine and its compounds. So having gone through the objectives, then we'll get into the introduction. Basically, the introduction is to tell us basically about chlorine. First of all, we know that chlorine is an element that occurs in group 7. in group 7 of the periodic table. It is a non-metallic element. With an electron arrangement of 287. And that, of course, is the one that guides us towards knowing that chlorine is in group 7. The fact that it has 7 electrons in the outermost energy level. Chlorine exists as a gas, and this gas exists as a diatomic molecule. So chlorine exists in gaseous form as a diatomic molecule. That is a molecule that is made of 2 atoms. So a diatomic molecule is a molecule that is made of 2 atoms. And that's why we write the formula for chlorine gas as Cl2, showing that it exists as a diatomic molecule, a molecule that is made up of 2 atoms. Naturally, chlorine exists not as an a pure element, but combined with other elements. That means it exists naturally as a compound. So it exists naturally in compounds such as sodium chloride, in rock salt, or in seawater. So sodium chloride can either exist as a rock salt, that is in solid form, or it can exist as a solution in the seawater. So basically, that's an introduction about chlorine. It's an element that occurs in group 7 of the periodic table. It's a non-metallic element with an electron arrangement of 287, hence group 7. It exists in gaseous form as a diatomic molecule, which is chlorine gas, Cl2. And then naturally, it occurs in compounds such as sodium chloride. And sodium chloride is mainly in rock salt and sea water. So the next thing that I would like us to go through is the laboratory preparation. Chlorine gas. How is chlorine gas prepared in the laboratory? And to prepare chlorine gas, you need concentrated hydrochloric acid, and you also need a strong oxidizing agent. So, for example, we can say that chlorine is prepared by oxidation of conch or concentrated hydrochloric acid using manganese 4-oxide. We can use manganese 4-oxide. We can also use potassium manganate 7. We can also use lead four oxide. All those are suitable oxidizing agents that can be used. So chlorine is prepared by oxidation, whereby concentrated hydrochloric acid is oxidized using manganese for rockside. And this reaction requires heat to speed up the reaction. Requires heat to speed up the rate of oxidation. So we're going to have a diagram. And this diagram shows how the setup is made. So we have a diagram showing the laboratory preparation of chlorine gas. And we are preparing the gas by oxidation of concentrated hydrochloric acid using manganese peroxide as the oxidizing agent. And we are saying that the reaction requires heat to speed up the reaction. So after the chlorine has been obtained here. It is passed through water to dissolve any impurities of hydrogen chloride gas that may be there. Of course, arising from conch hydrochloric acid. So any impurities of hydrogen chloride gas, they are absorbed at this point because they are highly soluble in water. Then the gas is dried by passing it through conch sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid, and then finally the gas is collected by downward delivery or upward displacement of air. So the gas being collected here is chlorine gas. To test that it is actually chlorine gas, a moist blue litmus paper is placed at the top of the gas jar to see the changes that will happen. So basically on that, we are saying that conch hydrochloric acid plus manganese peroxide is a solid. That reaction produces chlorine gas, which is being collected there. There is also manganese 2 chloride. And that is a solution plus water. So that is the equation for the reaction that takes place there. So to balance it, you can check the hydrogens. There are 2 oxygen. It's 2 and 1. Can make this to be 2. That is balanced. Chlorine, there are 2 and 2. That is 4. Can put a 4 there. 4 hydrogens as well. Manganese is 1. Oxygen, there are 2. And that equation is balanced as it is. So we are saying that the gas is then passed through water to absorb the highly soluble hydrogen chloride gas, which is an impurity. And then the gas is passed through conch sulfuric acid to remove moisture or to dry the gas. Then the gas is collected by downward delivery. Because it is denser than air. It is denser than air. So from that, we'll have an assignment. So the first question in the assignment, state how chlorine gas is prepared using manganese 4 oxide. Number two, why is chlorine gas passed through water? And B, concentrated sulfuric acid. And lastly, number three, write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction above. So we'll stop there. Until next time, goodbye.